Now, the four-time Olympic gold medalist who retired from the sport of competitive swimming but is just as active as ever. Big event in Vegas this weekend. Lenny Krayzelburg is here. Jessica's son swims thanks to you, and that could be said of thousands of kids locally.
Yeah, we've had our swim academy for the last 15 years, and it's all about water safety with our swim academies. We start as young as 3 months, so it's been, we're changing lives and really proud of and honored to be.
No question. I used to teach swim lessons for the city of Burbank in their pool as a lifeguard, but the kids were all 4 or 5 or 6. So then they're old enough to be scared.
Right. Well, we start them younger, so they don't even have the time to get scared yet. And we really love what we do and the impact we make.
No question about that. Does the Olympics seem like a long time ago, or you still got the form?
Well, the first Olympics were almost 20 years ago that wow. I swam. It's been quite some time, but obviously that's something that's part of me, and you know, I always reminisce back on it with a lot of great memories.
Where do you put your gold medals?
They're in the drawer.
Okay.
At home, yeah.
Do you put them around your neck, you know, on occasion?
All the time. No, okay.
What is the Los Angeles Current?
So Los Angeles Current is one of 8 professional swim clubs in the newly formed Professional Swim League. That was started this year. This is our inaugural season, and we're one of 8 teams, and I'm the general manager of that team.
All right, people pay an awful lot of attention to collegiate swimming. Obviously, people pay enormous attention to Olympic swimming. Is the idea here that that interest can be generated on a quote-unquote professional level?
Absolutely. That's the goal with this league. Obviously, swimming is the most popular sport at the Olympic Games, so there is attention for that. But in between the Olympics, it kind of fades back. And the idea is to really bring the sport to the forefront, to showcase our top athletes, to showcase the sport in general. And the idea is really to become mainstream.
All right. Frank and I are Speedos or shorts, or what would get us our best time?
Nowadays, it's more shorts.
Oh.
Because they are, yeah, it's the high-tech part of
but
it.
But I enjoy wearing the Speedos. I mean, it's.
You can do that in warm-ups.
Right. Okay. I'll do that.
And does all these technical innovations, because I remember the Speedos and the goggles and all that, does that matter? I mean, because obviously even a tenth of a second matters.
Oh, absolutely. Everything matters. And that's what, you know, the tech companies are always looking for a way to, you know, improve the equipment and to really help the athletes get to the best, you know, get the best performance out of it.
Should Sam continue to shave his back to increase his speed?
Just one side of it.
One side. Okay. All right.
All right. Jessica can do the butterfly, but it's hard.
No, I'm a bad swimmer, and I hold my nose when I jump in the pool.
That is a problem.
Yes, it is.
But you can always swim backstroke, though, so that way you can always breathe.
Or the good old doggy paddle that, you know, everybody
is there, because I would tend to think that a butterfly would certainly be the most difficult. Would you rank them in terms of difficulty? Or?
You can rank them, but it also depends on the distance that you're swimming. You'd think that breaststroke might be the easiest stroke, but if you swim a 200 breaststroke, it's actually a pretty tough stroke. Backstroke is really hard. The longer that you swim backstroke is very hard because it's very taxing on the legs, and legs are your biggest muscle that carries most oxygen. So once that gets tired, the rest of your body gets tired. So it really depends.
Having never swum competitively, this is all very interesting to me. Talk to us about this event this weekend.
So this weekend in Las Vegas, we have the final of our first inaugural season. It's four. The league had 8 teams. Now we're down to 4 teams. LA Current, Cali Condors, London Roar, and Energy Standard out of Turkey. And we're competing for the championship. And it's pretty exciting. And it's really, the focus is more on a team concept rather than individual racing. 14 men, 14 women on the team. And everyone scores points towards, you know, team total.
And is time everything still, or is that?
Everything is time,
right.
But again, it's, you know, you can get 8th place, but you're going to get 1 point. It might matter at the end of the competition.
And
that's what it's all about. It's about coming together more for a team goal and trying to win this championship.
Wow, they're actually putting a pool in the Mandalay Bay arena for this. More information on LA Current, head over to lacurrent.club. And the ISL finals are in Vegas this weekend at Mandalay. Ticket information, isl.global. They'll also be streaming on ESPN3. Lenny, thank you for what you've done and what you're doing.
Yeah,
thank you very much.
Thank you
for having me.
Great to see you.